Hey there, it's Cheryl with Distressed Textures, and today I'm going to show you how to texture a photograph. First thing I want to do is access my textures. I just downloaded the Artist Palette Watercolor Painterly from the distressedtextures.com site. They normally go straight to the download folder. I went ahead and copied them and pasted them to my desktop. That way I can access them easily. First thing I'm going to do is go up to the top, File, Open, and this should take me to my textures. And I think I'm going to pick out let's see, Evergreen. We'll go with the darker one right now. Okay, it's opened up in a separate window, so we have to get it over to our texture. And there's a couple ways that you, or excuse me, our image. There's a couple ways that you can do that. You can select the move tool, that's the little arrow at the top over here. You click the texture and hold and drag it over to the image. Don't drop it yet. Move your arrow as close to the center as you can and then hit let up, drop it. You might have to move it a little bit. And another way to do it is go back to the texture, make sure it's all selected, edit, copy, and then edit, paste. We've pasted the texture on top of the image, and you want to make sure that that's the case for texturing. You want the texture layer on top of the photograph. You need to have your layers palette open. If it's not, go up to the top where it says window up here, window, and make sure your layers is selected, which mine is. So first thing I'm going to do is go into the pull down menu over here to show you the different blending modes. Right now it's in normal. This is multiply, which I use probably 70% of the time. Another one that I use a lot of is just the overlay mode, soft light, and the hard light. So I'm going to go ahead and use the multiply mode right now so I can show you how to use masking. Obviously the barn is getting lost in all of this, so I am going to create a mask. Down here at the bottom is a little square with a circle in it. You're going to want to click that, and we have a white square next to the texture. Go ahead and click inside that white. And you're going to come over here to your tools and have your black paint on top. Select the paintbrush, excuse me, and then you're going to come over and just go over the areas that you don't want the texture to show through. If you erase too much, you just change the paint to white. Bump my eraser down a little bit. And this will go ahead and replace any of the spots where you went too heavy on the black. That's the background is still too dark, so I'm going to go ahead and select the texture itself again. And I'm going to go up to the top to Image, Adjustments, Brightness and Contrast. I'm going to bump up my brightness just a little bit. I'm going to go to Image, Adjustments, Hue, Saturation, so I can show you that you can play with the hue settings on here and get completely different effects. You can also change the saturation, remove some of the color, or you can go really crazy and increase the saturation. And the same thing with the lightness. You can bump up the lightness a little bit through there too. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and show you a couple other textures while we're at it. I'm deselecting the texture, and I'm going to keep it there in case I want to use it again as another layer. Going up to the top, File, Open. Going to be selecting Fleur Petal, Open. And then I'm going to be dragging that with my Move tool on top of my image. So click and hold, drag it over to the image, drop it in the center, and you may have to make an adjustment to move it. And then back over to the Layers palette, to the blending modes. I'm going to try the different ones. Multiply. I think I'm going to probably go with overlay on that. Yep. I'm going to turn that one off and get one more texture. Just trying to show you the different looks that you get from each texture. Let's go with, I'll go with conch. And this time I'm going to select all, edit, copy. And then I'm going to paste it. Try multiply, overlay. I think I'm going to stick with that Fleur. I was feeling this one. Now I'm going to, before I head out, I'm going to show you how to load your bird brushes. Over here on the Tools palette, you will select your brush tool. And then come up to the top toolbar. This is the preset picker. Click that little down arrow and then come over to this right arrow and click that and go down to load brushes. Some of the texture packs come with free bird brushes. This Artist Palette Watercolor Painterly happens to be one of them. So I'm going to go ahead and load the brushes. Again, you need to know where your items are, whether they're in your download folder or somewhere else. This one is in the folder of textures on my desktop, so I'm going to hit click it and press open. And then over here, the brushes are going to pop up. So I'm going to go ahead and select one that I want to use. Let's see. Oh, I like that one. Bump it down just a little bit because I want them to stay realistic size. I have my black paint selected and the opacity's at 93. I'm just going to bump it up a little bit. I don't usually put it at 100% because I don't want it overpowering. So I'm going to go ahead and put those down. I want to do it on top of my texture. So come over here and click the create a new layer and make sure it's above everything. So you have this blank layer above your texture and your image. And then go ahead and just click down for your birds. And that's it. I hope that you were able to get something out of this video. If you have any questions, you can email me at distresstextures@gmail.com. Thank you.